topic. The next topic is goes to spectra. Next topic goes to spectra. Of course, these spectras are following types. Spectras are following types. That is, emission spectra and absorption spectra. Emission spectra and absorption spectra. What is the definition of emission spectra? A spectrum which record radiation emitted by a substance. A spectrum which record radiation emitted by a substance are called emission spectra. So this emission spectra, emission spectrum obtained by the substance present in the excited state at high temperature. So spectra basically two types. These spectras are two types. That is, first one, emission spectrum. First one, emission spectrum. And second one is absorption spectrum. What is the definition of emission spectra? A spectra which record radiation. A spectra which record radiation emitted by a substance. A spectra which record radiation emitted by a substance is called emission spectra. So this emission spectra is excited state of high temperature. That means emission spectrum is obtained by the substance present in excited state to high temperature. So this emission spectra, bright line on dark plate. This is bright line on dark plate. So this is emission spectra. Of course, these emission spectras are again three types. The three types are: one, continuous spectrum, line spectrum, and band spectrum. So these emission spectras are again three types. Emission spectra are three types. These are three types. So that three types are continuous spectrum, line spectrum, band spectrum. So continuous spectrum, line spectrum, second part only, band spectrum. Now let us discuss continuous spectrum. Here
two colors. That means when prism
here violet is changed to indigo, indigo is changed to blue, blue is changed to green, green is changed to yellow, yellow is changed to orange, orange is changed to IR, that stands for infrared. So UV to violet, violet to indigo, violet to indigo, indigo to blue, blue to green, green to yellow, yellow to orange, orange to infrared. So that means all colors are in serial line. So that's why these are called what happened? Continuous spectrum. So that means when continuous spectrum, when narrow beam white light is passed through prism to get various fixture rays absorbed, that various fixture rays, then ultraviolet to indigo, indigo to blue, blue to green, green to yellow, yellow to orange, orange to infrared. So that means there is no gap between two colors. There is no gap between two colors. That's why the spectrum are called continuous spectrum. That's why the spectrum are called continuous spectrum. After the continuous spectrum, line spectrum. So here line spectrum, second one is line spectrum. Line spectrum means the spectra having various lines. The spectra having various lines are called line spectrum. The spectra having various lines are called line spectrum. Then third one is band spectrum. Third one is band spectrum. The spectra having various bands. The spectra having various bands are called band spectrum. So these are called what is emission spectrum. So what is the definition of emission spectrum? A spectrum which records radiation emitted by a substance. A spectra which records radiation emitted by a substance are called emission spectrum. So these emission spectra, what happened in the emission spectrum? Emission spectrum is obtained by the substance present in the excited state to high temperature. These emission spectra is absorbed bright line on dark plate. Bright line on dark plate. These emission spectra are again three types. That is continuous spectrum, line spectrum, band spectrum. Continuous spectrum means when narrow of beam, when beam of light sent to pass into the prism. When beam of light pass into the prism, this prism is absorbed. Seven vigyar color is absorbed. So that is the color name is vigyar. So line spectrum. That line spectrum means spectra having various lines. Spectra having various lines are called line spectra, band spectra. Spectra having various bands. Spectra having various bands are called band spectra. So this is what are the emission spectra. After that emission spectra, next second one is absorption spectra. Absorption spectrum or absorption spectra. Here absorption spectra means in that scene a spectra which record radiation emitted, that replace a spectra which record radiation observed by a substance. Here what is the definition? A spectrum which record radiation, which record radiation emitted by light. That means a spectrum which record radiation absorbed by a substance is called absorption spectra. Absorption spectra. So that means in the emission spectra, it emitted by a substance. So here in the absorption spectra, a spectra which record radiation absorbed by a substance are called absorption spectra. So in this emission spectra obtained by the substance present in the excited state. Here ground state to low temperature. Here ground state to low temperature. Next, these emission spectra, bright line on dark plate. These absorption spectra, dark line on bright plate. Dark line on bright plate. condition observed by a substance are called absorption spectra. These emission spectra is obtained by the substance present in exalted state to high temperature. Here absorption spectra, say again as it is, absorption spectra obtained by the substance present in ground state to low temperature. So this here ground state to low temperature, that is exalted state to high temperature. Bright, this emission spectra is absorbed bright line on dark plate. It's absorbed dark line on bright plate. So of course these are three types: continue, line, band. These are also three types: continue, line, and band. Continue spectrum means when prism of light, white light, is sent in the prism, when narrow of beam of light, when sent in prism to get various colors absorbed, that various colors belongs to Fibonacci color. Line spectra, spectra having various lines are called line spectra. Band spectra, spectra having various bands are called band spectra. After the topic magic number. So after the spectra, next topic goes to magic number. So what is the definition? Of course, magic numbers are 2, 8, 20, 50, 82, 126 are called magic number. So what is the definition of magic number? For example, if you take helium, helium atom number is 2, its mass number is 4. Its mass number is 4. So that means here mass number minus atomic number, total how much? 2. So here 2 number are called magic number. For example, next another example, oxygen. Oxygen atomic number is 8. Its mass number is 16. Mass number is 16. So what is the difference? Mass number minus atomic number equal to 8. That's why this oxygen are called magic number. The next example, calcium. Calcium atomic number is 20. Calcium atomic number is 20 and its mass number is 40. So what is the difference? 40 minus 20 equal to 20. That's why these 20 are called magic number. So another few example of magic number. Here lead. Lead its atomic number is 82. Lead its atomic number is 82 and mass number is 208. Its mass number is 208. What is the difference? 208 minus 82. 208 minus 82. So that's why 126. These 126 are called magic number. So what is the definition of magic number? So here when it is the mass number and atomic number, if elimination, you get what happened? 2, 8, 20, 50, 50, 82, 126 are called magic number. So the best example of magic number is helium. Helium atomic number is 2, its mass number is 4. That's why it's 2 are called magic number. Then oxygen, its atomic number is 8, its mass number is 60, the total 8, it is also called magic number. Then calcium, 20, 40, the total is 20, it is also magic number. Lead, 82, 208, the total 126, it is also called magic number. So this is magic number. After that magic number, we have to discuss decoding concept theory. Right. After that magic number, next topic is De Broglie concept. Basically, this De Broglie concept, according to Planck's quantum theory, its formula is, this formula is already discussed. E equal to h mu. This is the first equation. According to Einstein equation, E equal to mc square. This second equation. Now, comparing both, mc square equal to h mu. Mc square equal to h mu, but where mu equal to c by lambda. Substitute this by c by lambda in these three values. Mc square equal to h c by lambda. Now mc square equal to h by lambda. That means mc lambda equal to h. Mc lambda equal to h. That's why lambda equal to h by mc. So these De Broglie concept theories are again two types. The that is one standing view. Then first one is standing view and second one is non-standing view. Non-standing view. Here standing view means, what is the definition of standing view? The two waves, that means this is standing view, here this is one. In this standing view, the two waves will meet to each other. In standing view, the two waves will meet to each other. That means MVR equal to n lambda. MVR equal to n lambda. That means this is first wave, this second wave. The two waves will meet to each other are called standing view. In this standing view, the circumference of electron is equal to n lambda. The circumference of electron is equal to n lambda. So that what is the definition of non-standing view? Here, in this non-standing view, the two waves does not meet each other. The two waves does not meet each other. That does not meet to each other are called non-standing view. MVR is does not equal to n lambda. MVR is does not equal to m lambda. So here the circumference of electron is does not equal to n lambda. So here circumference means MVR, here the circumference of electron is does not equal to n lambda. This is standing and non-standing view. What is De Broglie concept theory? Then this De Broglie concept theory, according to Planck's quantum theory, E equal to h mu. E equal to h mu. According to Einstein equation, so what is the derivation? What is the Einstein? What is the Planck constant theory? We already discussed. So according to Einstein equation, E equal to mc square. So mc square equal to h mu, where mu equal to c by lambda, where mu equal to c by lambda. So that's why mc square equal to h mu, nothing but c by lambda. C by lambda, mc square equal to h by lambda, yet mc lambda is nothing but h, mc lambda is nothing but what happened? H, so lambda equal to h by mc, so lambda, where lambda equal to wavelength, what is the wavelength? The distance between two successive crust or trough are called wavelength. This wavelength is denoted by angstrom, nanometer, meter, centimeter, micrometer. Here h is nothing but Planck's constant. Here, m is nothing but mass of the electron. C equal to velocity of light. C equal to velocity of light. These De Broglie concept theories are what types? Two types. Standing view, non-standing view. What is the definition of standing view? In this standing view, the two waves will meet to each other. The two waves will meet to each other are called standing view. That means, the wave in which two ends will meet to each other are called standing view. This standing wave is also called constructive interference. This standing wave is also called constructive interference. Here, the circumference of electron is equal to L lambda. So this is standing view. What is non-standing view? The two waves will not meet to each other are called non-standing view. In this non-standing view, this non-standing view is also called destructive interference. This non-standing view is also called destructive interference. Here, the circumference of electron is does not equal to n lambda. So this is De Broglie concept theory. So what are the today we discussed three topics. So what is spectra? Spectra two types: emission spectra and absorption spectra. Next, after these emission spectra are made like three types: continuous spectra, line spectra, and band spectra. After that, absorption spectra. After absorption spectra, we discuss magic number. After that, magic number, De Broglie concept theory. So this is De Broglie concept theory. Next, based on concept, we have to discuss problem. Right? Okay. Next problems after De Broglie concept theory. Next, we have to discuss problem. Now let us first problem. Calculate the frequency of radiation whose wavelength is 3000 angstrom. Calculate the frequency of radiation whose wavelength is wavelength, whose wavelength is 3000 angstrom. Whose wavelength is 3000 angstrom. So this is the problem. Calculate the frequency of radiation whose wavelength is 3000 angstrom. Now what is the solution for this problem? Here we already discussed wavelength mean the distance between two surfaces of crust or trough or called wavelength. So what happened here? Lambda equal to wavelength. Lambda equal to wavelength. So wavelength units are angstrom, meter, centimeter, nanometer. How many here? 3000 angstrom. So we already discussed 1 angstrom equal to 10 power minus. So here calculate that means here angstrom equal to 3000 angstrom. So lambda equal to wavelength, that equal to 3000 angstrom. 1 lambda equal to 10 power, 1 lambda equal to 10 power minus 8 centimeter. So an angstrom equal to 3000 into 10 power minus 8 centimeter. 1 angstrom equal to, so this 3000, how can I write that? 3 into 10 cube into 10 power minus 8. So place into minus minus, that's 1 angstrom equal to 3 into 10 power minus 5. So according to here, what is calculate the frequency? Mu equal to c by lambda, where c equal to velocity of light. Where c equal to velocity of light, that value is 3 into 10 power 10. This is constant value. So by lambda. So what happened? Mu equal to c nothing but 3 into 10 power 10 by lambda equal to what happened? 3 into 10 power minus 5. So this 3 cancel. Now mu equal to 10 power 15. 10 power 15. So frequency unit is second inverse. Frequency unit is second inverse. So this is the one of the problem. Calculate the frequency of radiation whose wavelength is 3000 angstrom. So here angstrom is there. That angstrom means wavelength. Wavelength unit is angstrom, meter, centimeter, nanometer, micrometer. Lambda equal to wavelength, that equal to 3000 angstrom. 1 angstrom equal to already discussed 10 power minus 8 centimeter. So 1 angstrom equal to 3000 into 10 power minus 8 centimeter. So these 3000, how can I write that 3000? 3 into 10 cube into 10 power minus 8. So place into minus minus, that's right, 10 power minus 5. But we find in the given question frequency. Frequency formula is mu equal to c by lambda. This mu is the frequency of radiation, c equal to velocity of light, lambda equal to wavelength. Where lambda is already there, 3 to 10 power 5. See fundamental value, 3 to 10 power 10. Substituting all values, so what happened? 3 get cancelled. Mu equal to 10 power 15. Its unit is second inverse. So this is complete first problem. Now to be continue problem. So as it is, calculate the frequency of radiation. Calculate the frequency of radiation. The frequency of radiation. Radiation whose wavelength is 2000 angstrom. Whose wavelength is 2000 angstrom. So this is also similar to first problem. So what is that here? Now here solution. Lambda equal to wavelength. Okay. Lambda equal to wavelength. Here wavelength how many? 2000 angstrom. 2000 angstrom. We already. So 1 angstrom equal to 10 power minus 8 centimeter. Yes. 1 angstrom equal to 10 power minus 8 centimeter. Now 1 angstrom equal to what happened in the given question? 2000 is there. 2000 into 10 power minus 8 centimeter. But 1 angstrom equal to what happened? This 2000, how can I write 2 into 10 cube? 2 into 10 cube into 10 power minus 8 centimeter. So that's it. So what happened here? 2 into 10 power minus 5. So what is the frequency formula? Mu equal to c by lambda. Where c equal to velocity of light. What is the velocity of light here? Mu equal to 3 into 10 power 10 by 2 into 10 power minus 5. So if remove of that, second inverse. Second inverse. So this is next second problem. So what is the second problem? Calculate the frequency of radiation whose wavelength is 2000 angstrom. So here angstrom is there. That's why that is wavelength. Wavelength is denoted by angstrom, centimeter, meter, nanometer, or micrometer. Okay. So lambda equal to wavelength. That equal to almost 2000 angstrom. So here angstrom is there. That's why 1 angstrom equal to 10 power minus 6 centimeter. So 1 angstrom equal to 2000 into 10 power minus 8. 2000 how can write? 2 into 10 power 3 into 10 power minus 8. So 3 into minus 8 what happened? Minus 5. Mu equal to c by lambda. Mu equal to c its fundamental value. 3 into 10 power 10 by 2 into 10 power minus 5. 3 by 2 nothing but 10 into 5 is nothing but 1.5 to 10 power 15 second inverse. This is complete second problem. So next problem. Calculate the frequency of radiation whose wavelength is 600 nanometer. Calculate the frequency of radiation.
Whose wavelength is 2000 angstrom. But in the
lambda equal to wavelength. Lambda equal to wavelength. Lambda equal to wavelength. It's denoted by how much? It's how much? 2000 angstrom. So what happened here? Lambda equal to 2000 angstrom. So that equal to 2 into 10 cube into, we already discussed it, 10 power minus 8. 1 angstrom equal to 10 power minus 8. That's why 2 into 10 power minus 5. But in the given question, free wave number means mu bar equal to 1 by lambda. This is wave number formula. Mu bar equal to 1 by lambda. That's why mu bar equal to 1 by 2 into 10 power minus 5. 1 by 2, that means 1 by 2 into 10 power minus nothing but write this one. Okay. So what happened? Mu bar equal to 1 by 2 nothing but 0.5. 0.5 into 10 power into 10 power minus. So this minus 5 is nothing but plus 5. So mu bar equal to 0.5 into 10 power 5. So nothing but here 5 into 10 power minus 4. 5 into 10 power. So that means here 5 means, here 0.5 into 10 power 5 means, if you move this point, what happened? Here power also remove one power. That means 5. This is 5 into 10 power 4. So this is what is calculated the wave number of radiation whose wavelength is 2000 angstrom. But wave number unit is what happened? Centimeter inverse. Wavelength, wave number is mu bar equal to how much? Lambda equal to wavelength, that equal to 2000 angstrom. 1 angstrom equal to 10 power minus 8 centimeter. Of course, 2 into, then how can I write this one? 2 into 10 cube into 10 power minus 8, 2 into minus 5. Mu bar formula is mu bar equal to wave number formula is mu bar equal to 1 by lambda. Mu bar equal to 1 by 2 into 10 power 5. It's nothing but 0.5. If you remove this point, so 5 into 10 power 4. If you remove this point, here power also decrease of one number. That's why 5 into 10 power 4 centimeter inverse. This is